Okay, Rabotai, continuing on our series of Derech HaPsak, the different foundations of Psak Halacha by Edut HaMa'arav, the Sfaradim, which is mainly we're talking about Morocco, but this is very similar as well to Tunisia, Algeria, and Turkey as well, which we would call the Sfaradim. This is going to be a little bit different than Edut HaMizrach, especially how Edut HaMizrach are posek nowadays. And this is going to be a very, very important shiur to understand how the psakim that are based according to Kabbalah, and when we say Kabbalah, we're going to see that that means many different things. It means the Zohar HaKadosh, it means the Arizal, it means the Rav Chaim Vital, it means Mekubalim that received from the Arizal that are not Rav Chaim Vital, and then there's the later Mekubalim. And then we could discuss, and then we're going to discuss how each of these play regarding Chachmei Morocco. This could go on a long time. This topic really has a lot to be said on. So, but I'm going to try to keep it pointed and very to the point. What I'm not going to speak about, at least today, is the big machloket, whether we follow the Zohar HaKadosh keneged the poskim. There's a big discussion whether we follow the Zohar HaKadosh keneged the poskim. If the Gemara argues on the Zohar HaKadosh, we follow the Gemara because the Gemara knew it, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai's opinion. We say probably knew and still was machria not that way. Question is, when the Gemara doesn't talk about something and the Zohar HaKadosh does. And there's a few important Bet Yosefs about this. One of the Bet Yosefs is in Or HaChaim, Siman Chaf Hei, where the Agur writes and asks a question, how do we argue on the Zohar and we do two brachot on Tefillin? And the Bet Yosef says, En yodea lama tama al ze yoter mi kama dinim shekatav Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai b'sefer HaZohar, hefech maskanet de Talmuda, ve'en poskim ela maskanet Talmuda. ותאמה, משום דאפילו אם היו יודעים דברי רשבי, לא אבי חי שילו במקום דפליג התלמודה דידן. This is what we mentioned, that the Bet Yosef says, when the Gemara argues on Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, we don't follow Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, because the Gemara knew that, and still wasn't posek that way. Nevertheless, the Bet Yosef in Siman Kuf Mem Aleph has a long arichut, whether somebody who goes up to the Torah reads quietly with the Shliach Tzibur, and he brings from the Zohar HaKadosh that you shouldn't read at all. And then the Bet Yosef adds the following words. Me'achar shelo niskar ze betalmud, behedya, lo shafkinan divrei haposkim mipre divar haposkim. That means that even though the poskim say to read out, to read together with the Shas, but Zohar doesn't say that. So therefore the Bet Yosef really seems to say that we follow the Zohar even bimkom haposkim. The Radbaz argues, and there's Rabbi Yoshua Maman in Emek Yoshua Chelek Bet, Rabbi Shalom Misas in several places, Chelek Aleph in Siman Yud Aleph of Shemesh Umagen discusses this, and really there's strong reasoning to say that we are posek like the Zohar HaKadosh, even though some say not that way. But there's strong reasoning to say we are posek like the Zohar HaKadosh. Just one more thing in this regard. The Shiari Knesset Agdola brought down the Mishtabura Simen Chafei writes that we follow like the poskim. The Emek Yoshua say, no, we follow like the Zohar. Rav Ovadia Yosef says we're posek like the poskim. And Rabbi Shalom Misas also says we go like the poskim. So that's a separate diyun. And that will have ramifications to it. The question more at hand that I wanted to focus on is, to what degree do the minhagim of Kabbalah play a role in being posek halacha according to Chachmei Morocco? And when I printed Magen Avot Eben HaEzer, it was even Yoredea in the year 2010, I believe. So I wrote a piece about this topic, about how much Kabbalah plays a role. And I brought a few places where we see that we didn't follow Kabbalah. Different than Edut HaMizrach. For example, Birkat Me'en Sheva on Leil Pesach, when it falls out on Shabbat, Maran says not to say it. Nevertheless, the minhag in Yerushalayim is to say it, like the minhag Bet El. We don't wear talit and tefillin on Tisha B'Av day. The minhag in Yerushalayim is like the minhag mikubalim of Bet El, that they wear tefillin. On Yamim Noraim, we say the tefillah of Yamim Noraim out loud. What I mean by that is that there's one person in the kahal that says out loud, not very loud, but in a voice that could be heard, the Shmona Esre. This I remember growing up in Montreal, there'd always be one person who would say the tefillah, Ufchein, tzadikim yiru v'yismachu, v'sharim yalozu. And this is the opinion of Maran in Siman Tav Kuf Pei Bet, because people are not used to the tefillah. Edut HaMizrach, don't do that because they're choshesh al pi kabbalah, that tefillah should not be said out loud. Nowadays, most B'nai Torah also don't follow this minhag either. It takes away the concentration, but that was definitely the minhag. There's also a very important, very indicative halacha that Maran says not to say the bracha hanoten layef koach in the morning b'shemu malchut. That's what Maran writes, because it wasn't a bracha that was nitkana b'gmara. Rabbi Shalom Misas writes, he remembers this is the minhag of Meknes. Not to say the bracha, anoten lev koach b'shemu malchut. Say baruch, anoten lev koach. Understandably, most people, even by Edut HaMa'arav, do the bracha, anoten lev koach b'shemu malchut. And so too is written, because it's written in the works of the Arizal, that this bracha should be said. So from these halachot and a few more, I suggested that the minhag in Morocco was much less based al pi chachmei Kabbalah more than other edot like Edut HaMizrach. Then about a year ago, Gaon Rav Yosef Peretz from Panama wrote to me the following letter, and he pointed out an important nekuda that needs to be pondered on. He says, when we talk about Kabbalah, there are many different levels of Kabbalah. There's the Kabbalah before the Arizal. There's the Zohar HaKadosh, of course. There's before the Arizal, which was the Ra'avad, Rav Yitzchak Sagin Nahor, the Ramban, and other Mikubalim. And there's the Zohar HaKadosh. And then, I'm sorry, I mentioned the Zohar HaKadosh. Then there's the Arizal. Now there's the Arizal of Rav Chaim Vital, and there's also the Arizal based on other students, like the Matzad Shimurim, and other students that went the path of the Arizal, but not the Rav Chaim Vital. And it's known that Rav Chaim Vital was the Ikar Masoret of the Arizal. Then you have Mikubalim that came afterwards, like the Ma'aram Mirikanati, Rabbeinu Bachaye. Well, he was even before the Ma'arochot Elokim, and there was the Hechal HaKodesh, the Maram Elbaz, that didn't even see the Arizal. You guys hear me? Yeah, he didn't even see the Arizal. He didn't even see the Arizal. So, and then there's later Mikubalim. There's the Rashash. There's the Rashash, and there's throughout the generations there was other Mikubalim as well. So it's very hard, you know, when we talk about Mikubalim. So who are we talking about? So here, and he proves that a lot of the examples that I gave, we're not talking about the Arizal. And that's a very important point that he brought up. And I agree fully with this point, which is there's an important discussion to have to clear all misconceptions. Was the Torah of the Arizal, especially in the pathway of Rav Chaim Vital, was that accepted in Morocco? So I remember once I was learning with Rabbi Avram Amar, Zecher Tzadik Livracha. His father was a great posek of Meknes. He was the Rosh Yeshiva of Or Baruch, a great Talmid Chacham, and he showed me there a manuscript of Kabbalah, and seemed to be a very reputable manuscript of Kabbalah. And I asked him, why doesn't he print it? He said he showed it to Rav Yaakov Hillel, who was his mechutan. Children married each other. Rav Yaakov Hillel said they can't really print it because it doesn't go with the common way that Kabbalah is learnt nowadays. So what does that mean? I don't remember if it meant that it was not based on the Arizal, which Bechlal is not learned today, or not even based on the Rashash, which is also not so popular today. I don't remember. But in Morocco, it was clear that there was a lot of Kabbalah before the Arizal. Like I mentioned to you, the Echal HaKodesh of Maram Elbaz, which I'll just mention to you. I think I mentioned this beforehand. The Maram Elbaz, he wrote a sefer, Echal HaKodesh. The Mishnah Brura brings him down. He was from Tarudant. The Mishnah Brura brings him down in Siman Gimel in regards to washing Netilat Yadayim when somebody goes out of the bathroom, washing with a kli. He is the makor to say that we wash with a kli. And the Magen Avram brings in, Mishnah Brura brings it, and he's not so clear with it. But many Ashkenazim are choshesh, and they do Netilat Yadayim with a kli. The Moroccan minhag is not to be careful to do Netilat Yadayim when you go outside of the bathroom with a kli. Rabbi Shalom Misas writes this, as well as most Chachmei Edut HaMizrach as well. Or Ben Sin Mutzafi brings all the Chachmei Edut HaMizrach weren't makpid with a kli. So it comes out that the Ashkenazim are choshesh for the Hechal HaKodesh, one of Chachmei Morocco, brought down in the Mishnah Brura Magen Avram. And the Moroccans are not choshesh for that. Irony, but that's how it goes in there. So there was Kabbalah that he was not based al pi the Arizal. But once the Arizal hit, it came at the end, let's say, of the 1600s. Then at the end of the 1500s, I would say, the beginning of the 1600s. Then there's indications that Chachmei Morocco adopted the Arizal categorically as the Mara de Atra in Kabbalah, without a suffix. There was a Chevrat Mikubalim in Marrakesh, a very important Chevrat Mikubalim. If you ever visit, you'll see that in the middle of the cemetery, they're buried there all together. One of them, his name was Rabbi Shlomo Amar. Another was called Rabbi Avram Azulai, not the Chesed LeAvram that's buried in Hebron, the great-grandfather of the Chida. This is Rabbi Avram Azulai from Marrakesh. There was Rabbi Avram Ben Musa, which we were zoche to put out his writings on Masechet Yoma. There's a very fundamental sefer called Shita Ktav Yad on Masechet Yoma that all the yeshivas learned based on Rabbi Avram Ben Musa. Rabbi Avram Ben Musa eventually escaped from Morocco to Tunisia. He's buried there. It's a whole story. He's buried where there's a car rental place in Tunis. It's where his kever is. And not long ago, we tried to contact the owner to make sure that his kever remains untouched. Very, very holy Jew. He has many, many hearot on the Etz Chaim and on the Zohar HaKadosh. And it's definitely the halakha that was... That went according to the Arizal and the Etz Chaim. Rav Yaakov Ibn Tzur has haga'ot on the Etz Chaim. The Rav Yaakov Maraji, who was the Rav of Rav Avram Ben Musa, wrote many, many, many Sfarim on the Zohar HaKadosh, and also heavily influenced based on the Arizal. These are all Sfarim that are common Kabbalah that was based according to the works of the Arizal. So it's clear that once the Torah of the Arizal came to Morocco, that became the norm. I'll just bring you a few more proofs. There was one Rav called Rav Elisha Ashkenazi. Rav Elisha Ashkenazi was the father of Natan HaAzati, the prophet that publicized Shabtai Tzvi. Natan HaAzati. Very big controversy. If he's the one who wrote the Sefer Chemdat Yamim, maybe we'll speak about that another time. But Rav Elisha Ashkenazi, some claim that he is the one that brought the Torah of the Arizal to Morocco. He was actually the Rav of the Orach Chaim HaKadosh's grandfather, who was the Moro v'Rabo of the Orach Chaim HaKadosh. Rav Elisha Ashkenazi, he was a Shadar, that means he was a Shaliach from Eretz Israel. There was the Sefer Ma'arot Sdei HaMachpelah from Rabbi Moshe Ibn Tzur from Migurashi Castilia, which is a Kitzur of Kitve Arizal. There was Rabbi Yitzchak Tzaba, who writes in Kavanot of the Arizal. There's Rabbi Yaakov Pinto, who was also one of the great Chachamim of Marrakesh. And I didn't actually bring out the point that these Chachamim Marrakesh, Rabbi Avram Azulai, Rabbi Yaakov Pinto, Rabbi Avram Ben Musa, and Rabbi Shlomo Amar, they were all contributors to the Sefer Mikdash Melech al Zohar. I remember when I visited Rav Chaim Pinchas Scheinberg once, he had the Mikdash Melech on his table. It's a very commonly used Sefer on the Zohar HaKadosh, and it's also heavily influenced by the works of the Arizal. So you have Rabbi, and later generations, the Rabbi Yaakov Abuchatzera doesn't move without the works of the Rav Chaim Vital. Rabbi Rafael Moshe Elbaz from Sofro has many Sfarim, Arba Shomrim, Eden Mikedem. All of these are based on Rav Chaim Vital. So here you have it, that Chachmei Morocco not only adopted the Arizal, they were very, very involved, wrote a lot on it, and it was something that was very common. If that's the case, it begs a question. Why don't we hear more hagdamot, more halachot, that were based on the Arizal than we should? I mentioned to you a list of things that don't go according to Kabbalah, and I'll just give you a few examples that we don't go according to Mikubalim that were like the Arizal. Baruch She'amar, we have a common nusach that we say nowadays, which is Paz, Rosho Ketem Paz, Paz Tevot, 87 words to it, which is the common Baruch She'amar that we have. But in Morocco, they had the longer nusach of Baruch She'amar. I know some synagogues, still today, they do the longer nusach of Baruch She'amar. Neged the Arizal. In Shara Kavanot, he writes not to do that. Another example. In Tfilat Musaf, we do the nusach, the common nusach nowadays, is Tikanta Shabbat, correct? What? Yes. We're good? You hear me? Did you hear about Baruch She'amar? Did you hear the example of Baruch She'amar? So in Baruch She'amar, I'll just repeat that, we have a common nusach of the Paz Tevot, which is the 87 words. But then that's based on the Arizal. But the original Moroccan minag was to do the long Baruch She'amar, which some synagogues do till today. Furthermore, in Tfilat Musaf of Shabbat, we do the Nusach Tikanta Shabbat, which is the Arizal. But the old Moroccan custom, based on the Sharak Avanot, is Limoshet Sivita. Birkat Anuten Layef Koach. Many places in Morocco said it without Shemu Malchut, which was neged the Arizal. How they set up the lulav. Many places in Morocco didn't do like the Arizal. They set up the lulav like the Shulchan Aruch, which is three adasim on one side, two on another side. Why is it then? If the Arizal was so strong in Morocco, why wasn't it that in these examples that I mentioned, and there are others, that they didn't follow the Arizal? So here, I want to present to you an approach that I think was the approach of, in general, of Chachmei Morocco. And this is based on the Mikubalim themselves. First of all, Shara Kavanot writes in the Hagot of Rav Shmuel Vital that even though Rav Chaim Vital wrote that you shouldn't say the Pizmonim that the Rabbanei Acharonim were mitaken, nevertheless, when he was Shaliach Tzibur on the Kahal on Yamim Noraim, he would do all the viduyim that are written because minagam shel Yisrael Torah. That means, even though the Arizal held one thing, he didn't, for the Tzibur, he did something different. One of the great Rabbanim of Yeshivat Bet El, Rav Yisrael Yaakov Al-Ghazi, writes in his Sefer Shalmei Tzibur, Dav Zayin Amud Bet, Harbe Me'od Tzarich Lizaer, Kol Ish Mi'Yisrael. A person is very careful. He says, Yohara is a terrible thing. Yohara is being more presumptuous in the public than you should. Not to show off in front of those who are makel like the Gemara and like the Poskim. Ki al ken tzarich leinayik b'minagi arav b'shalom mishor b'eno leben kono. A person wants to do it like the Arizal privately. Ve'lo yitra'e b'fnei atzibur k'shu machmir o mekil. She'oseh m'pnei divrei arav hefech m'divrei ashas v'poskim. That he's showing that he's doing opposite from the shas u'poskim. And especially according to what the Radbaz writes, that if you have a machloket, Kabbalah and Gemara, you go according to the Gemara. And if it's not in the Gemara, you go according to Kabbalah. You have to be very careful. And therefore, he ends off, he says, be very careful. Even the Rav Chaim Vital himself would not do things different from like the Arizal in public. So here you have it. You have explicitly a edut from Chachmei Mikubalim, that you have to be very careful if you're going to be noeg like the Arizal, not to do it in public. On the other hand, the poskim keep on being done, whether the Zohar is cholek on the poskim. We follow the Zohar. What do you mean? We just said that you shouldn't do the Zohar in public. So that's a big question. So I found in Shelut Tshuvot Vayashev Vayam Rav Yaakov Hillel and Chelik Aleph Siman Chet and Chelik Gimel Od Bet, writes an important chiluk in this regard. And I think this is a very true chiluk. It says there are two different types of halachot. There's one that you have a machloket whether to put on tefillin on Chol HaMoed or not, or how to put the direction of your bed, or whether chiyuv yibum to chiyuv chalitza. And that is that the mikubalim themselves are telling you what's the halacha. They're coming to tell you what's pshat in the halacha or hachra'a. It's putting in its opinion. Here, when you have a machloket between the Kabbalah and the halacha, it is very logical to say that we should follow alpi Kabbalah, Some say no, you follow Piposkim. But when we follow the Kabbalah, we're not following it as an extra Chumrah. We're saying this is the Halakha, there's the Machloket, and Kabbalah is saying to Paskin this way. That everyone does. That everyone understands. That's why everyone nowadays doesn't wear tefillin on Chol HaMoed. Zohar says no, the Halakha is not to put tefillin on Chol HaMoed. However, there are other things that are Midat HaChasidut, that are going against the Gemara. The Gemara tells you not to wear tefillin on Tisha B'Av. Or the Gemara tells, and Chachmei Mikubalim want to be Machmir. Then already you're going to have more of an issue. Because then you want to be Machmir more than what's written. Then you have to be careful that this doesn't enter in Yoharam. For example, Tfilin de Rabbeinu Tam. In Morocco, nobody ever wore Tfilin de Rabbeinu Tam in public. It was a chutzpah she'en kamo. Well, who do you think you are? Wearing tefillin the Rabbeinu Tam, where you are going to be more machmir than everyone else. I personally wear tefillin the Rabbeinu Tam. Why? I asked this question to Rabbi Yashin, and I told him that our custom is not to wear tefillin the Rabbeinu Tam, but it was because of Yohara, because it was presumptuous. But now every single Baal Tshuva that gets married, who in the street, they don't know Benyamina Musmolam, they wear tefillin the Rabbeinu Tam. Shulchan Aruch says, Tov latzat yidei shneihem. So what should I do? He says, no, nowadays you should wear, because the inyan of Yohara got weakened in this regard. So I started wearing. I'm not saying others argue. Others will say no. Our minag was Rabbi Shalom Isas, till his last days, never wore tefillin the Rabbeinu Tam. Rabbi Baruch Toledano was a big chassid. He would wear them in private. In public, no way. There was a hanhaga in Morocco never to do things according to Kabbalah in public because they were very careful on this inyan of Yohara, which nowadays basically went out the window. People are machmir on things that they don't have the right to be machmir. To be machmir, you have to be on a certain level. You don't have the right to be machmir. Lo kol harotze lavo litol et Hashem yavo v'yitol. But now that became the style, we'll call it. The shelot u'tshuvot hare'im, which was almost a Rishon, right? Rabbi Eliyahu Mizrahi. He writes in Chelek Aleph. He says, "En anu yochlim leachriach ha'am bedavar miadvarim haromzim la'elyonim." You can't force the public to do things that are ba'elyonim. The Rav Chemdat Hayamim, which was based on Kabbalah, the whole sefer, he writes in Shabbat Perek Yud Chet about learning Mikra Balayla. Listen to this, Chemdat Yamim. He says, "Mi she'enu baki ela b'mikra." Somebody who doesn't know how to learn Gemara. Are you going to tell him that he shouldn't learn Mikra b'alayla? He's going to be mevatel Torah mikol kol. U'bedavar hazeh shagu rabim mitomsei Torah shelo yadu lekalkel hamishpat bedivrei Rav. They don't know how to balance Divrei Arizal. They think that, oh, the Arizal says it, so even for the Pshutei Ha'am, it's okay. The Arizal is not for every single Tom, Dick, and Harry. And this is what the Shalmei Tzibor wrote as well, as I mentioned to you, that kol amit yaher nofel begehinam, and a person wants to do that izal, he's a hacham, he's a chassid, he does it beno leben atzbo. This was the approach of Chachmei Morocco, that they fully held of the Arizal and of Rav Chaim Vital, but they didn't force it on the public at all. Whereas in Edut HaMizrach, it became much more accepted to force the Hanagot of Kabbalah in public. Look at the Sefer Ben Ishchai. Look at the Minhage Bet El. Now we'll get to... Now there's... Bet El was a yeshiva in Yerushalayim. Because of Minhage Bet El, people were tefillin on Tisha B'Av, neged the Minhag. I used to pray on Tisha B'Av with Rabbi Shalom Misas. I remember at night, he would say, "Nobody come with tefillin next day. Anybody comes with tefillin, don't come here. Don't bring your tefillin. Go somewhere else." And there's other inyanim that are mushpa al pi Kabbalah that are not from Rav Chaim Vital. They're from Chaside Betel or they're from the Rashash. Here in Morocco, it wasn't a mechayev as much. Rabbi Yaakov Abuchatzer, it's known in a few places, he didn't follow the Rashash. As a matter of fact, the Rashash once came to Rabbi Mesod Abuchatzer, Baba Sali's father, Rabbi Yaakov's son, in a dream and said, "Why doesn't your father follow my anagot?" And apparently Rabbi Yaakov said, We don't follow in this area. How to hold a cup of Kiddush, Rabbi Yaakov had a way, not like the Rashash. You have to hold the plate, Rabbi Yaakov held. There's a few areas where he didn't follow the Masoret of the Rashash. Of course, they could have learned Rashash. But in Eduta Mizrach, especially in Yerushalayim, it became the only way. And it became like either this way or no way. And that's what's more commonly learned nowadays. Just saying, by Chachmim Morocco, there's no doubt that the Arizal and Rav Chaim Vital was the path of Psak. There's no doubt. But the later Mekubalim, it depended case by case basis. They weren't as Meshubad to the later Mekubalim, definitely not of Bit El, and definitely not of the Rashash as much as others. Which is why you're going to find a discrepancy. And going back to the examples that we said beforehand about Tisha B'Av. And about, what other examples did we give? About Sheva Brachot. Me'en Sheva on Lel Pesach. That was Minag Betel to say it. We didn't go that way. Now, on the other hand, not saying Shmona Yisrei B'Kol Ram, that was mostly because of the Hamonam. So each one of these cases has to be examined on its own. A lot, in other words, men sheva bebet hachatanim, we didn't do it, but that's not coming because, not like the Arizal, from the Rashash, people started saying men sheva in birkat chatanim. This happened a lot during Corona. Do we say men sheva in parking lots? So according to the Rashash, you would say it, but according to the Maran, we don't say it. And that's our minhag till today. Me'en sheva lel Pesach, as I mentioned. Talitu tisha be'av b'tisha be'av, as I mentioned. All of these are cases where we weren't mishubad to the Kabbalah the same way that we find in Chasidei Bet El. So I think I'm going to. I think we mentioned a lot of stuff. I'd like everyone to absorb it. But basically, the point being is that the Kabbalah by Chachmei Morocco was rock solid, based on the Arizal and Rav Chaim Vital, but it was not something that was forced upon the Tzibur. And then there's another category of Chachmei Kabbalah throughout the generations, that it depended case by case. Morocco didn't go with Chasidei Bet El and Divrei HaRashash like other Edot. Of course, it held sometimes that way, but like other Edot, as a general rule, it didn't. And when there's a machloket between the Zohar and the Poskim, we're going to have some Poskim say one way, some Poskim say another. I don't think that has to do specifically with Chachmei Morocco, but it definitely has it's definitely an important piece to it, that sometimes the Zohar is going to be machriya, and even the Hamonam is going to keep, because the Zohar is coming to be machriya what the halakha would be in such cases. Okay? I think we covered this topic. We should speak another time about the Chemdat Yamim, because in Morocco they had a great ashpan, the Chemdat Yamim, but that'll be another time.